So what I want you guys to do right now before we get into the, you know, independent versus signing a record label deal is I want you to get a piece of paper and I want you to draw a line across and a line down, and we're going to go through some pros and cons of being signed versus being independent. You know, because there's pros and cons to both. Being independent, man, like, you get to own your own music. You're beholden to nobody. You can release it whenever you want. You can say whatever you want. You can release as much of it as frequently or as far apart as you want. You can release a record every year, every 6 months, an EP if you want. You can release a new album every 2-3 years and then just tour the junk out of it. You know, you can do whatever you want, and you own 100% of it. You own the masters. You own the publishing. You get full rights when you sign and get a sync placement. You have to give 50% of it away to the label. You don't have to give part of the radio royalties away when you get played on radio if you go independently. You can still sign with a booking agent. You can still sign with the manager. You can still get sponsorship deals being independent. The thing is, you can still build a team being independently. You can hire a publicist. You can hire a radio tracker. It's just the upfront costs, really, is what sometimes discourages independent artists. But, you know, if you put the cash up front, then you get paid right up front, you know? And whoever insulates themselves from risk insulates themselves from success. Sometimes you got to put a bit of risk out. And who better to take a risk on than yourself? Put the money in, invest in yourself, and if you win and you hit big, you get the rewards, as opposed to 20-30% like I got. The reason I went independently is because I found I was spending more money than the label. I was working harder than the label, and yet they're reaping all the benefits. Forget that, man. If I'm investing all my time touring, doing, I'm bleeding, living this thing out. I'm not going to be slaves to these guys, you know? That's what this magazine article, it's an old magazine, Feed Magazine, friends of mine who ran this, and they're talking about how music, the new cotton, and just being enslaved to the labels. But, you know, the labels have their place too, and we'll talk about that in a second. This isn't going to be an all beat up the record labels thing. I'll flip the script a little bit here. But let's talk about this, because I want you to understand what you'd be giving up as an independent artist. If you don't like people telling you to change your songs for radio, well, then don't sign with a label in some cases, because a lot of the times they want you to fix your songs for radio. And you know what, as an independent artist, I sometimes fix my songs still for radio because I want radio success. You know, me as an artist, I want radio success because I've seen what happens. It sells a crap load of records, helps my touring, helps my income a lot. When radio works, man, it's amazing. You know, when it works, it just can generate a ton of income. And when you are independently and you own all your publishing, if you have radio success, that means you get all the royalties. Sound Exchange, I talked about this in one of my other courses, you get 95% instead of 40%, because whoever owns the master gets the majority of the income. And I could talk about all the different income streams. This is just the whole thing. But let's go to the label side for a second. You know, when you sign with the label, you get the whole machine going for you. You hopefully do. You know, you hopefully get a whole team of people working for you. If you sign a major deal and you have a major radio hit, that normally that label has departments or offices in different countries that a small label might not have, and definitely not an independent artist, and has relationships and has this whole system just pumping for you. I watched it from my friends in the band Magic and just see the whole system just crushing it for them. It's amazing when you do get that type of a deal. It's a lot rarer, though, and you know what? When you sign with the label, they're a bigger ship, and they take a lot longer to make decisions. And you got to understand, if you sign with the label, you could just get shelved. Depending on what's in the contract and depending how good your lawyer was, you could just get shelved as an artist and not release any records, and they won't let you release any records, so you got to be careful of that. You got to make sure you got clauses in there so that they have to release the record at some point in time or release you out of your contract. You know, obviously, going independent or getting signed, you know, them giving you a big advance to make the record if you don't have the money. You know, it's great, you know. Get you started. Get people believing in you first. Getting a booking agent. And my whole thing is sign with the label when you're ready, so when you can negotiate a good deal. Use them and then get out. You know, it's not the end of the journey. It's part of the journey. Think of this as always as a long-term career, not a short-term career. Always think long-term, 10, 15 years, not 2, 3. Dang, man, one of my record contracts I signed for, they had rights to the record for 7 years. That is a long time. You got to think of this as a long game, not the short game. There's so many other benefits of signing with a label. There really is. They have relationships with radio stations. They have relationships with certain movie placements that you couldn't get with when you're independent. Yes, you can hook up with music supervisors and you can go to the sync summits and all that stuff, but there's still some relationships that you need a label for. There's just certain things they have, but there's certain things that independent artists have that they don't have access to. But I just want you to understand that there's definitely pros and cons. I'm hitting a few roadblocks because I'm independent with radio this time. Some stations are going to be super supportive now, and some are going to be like, oh, he's not really with the label anymore, so they're giving us a little bit of a pushback, which we've never had before. It's like, come on, you just played all my other songs. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? But it's radio. It's politics. It's the game, and it's frustrating sometimes. But you know what? It's all a part of it, and you got to just say sometimes, okay, I'm going to just keep fighting this battle, and I'm going to figure it out. But again, start thinking about the different pros and cons of signing versus being independent. You know, having that whole machine. You know, sometimes a label will help you find a manager. They will help you find a booking agent. They will help you get on tours. I'll buy you on tours. They'll get you in front of some people. They can quantum leap your career. Yes, they can do that. Not all deals, but some can. They can quantum leap you. If there's other artists on there that you want to get with, well, they have the relationships there, right? So they can maybe put you on a tour with another act a little bit easier. But again, same thing though. But if you sign with the booking agent and you're independent, you can talk to your booking agent and say, hey, you book these guys. Get me on a tour with them. I'll buy on. I'll do whatever. Can you get me on there? I think I'd be a good fit. So it works both ways, and you're leveraging relationships here. You're leveraging money. And again, independently, one option is you could borrow money from the bank and release your record yourself and pay back the loan. And guess what? You still own the music. Guess what happens when you pay back the advance with the record label? You don't own the music. They own it. If you sign a traditional or probably a 360 deal, they own 100% of it. So remember, just because you're getting that advance, it's not for any reason here. This is a business. You're an investment, remember, not an artist to them. So think about it. You know, can you and the band, or you as a solo artist, can you work for the money? I definitely don't encourage going into debt, but I'd rather you go and believe in yourself and invest in yourself and borrow the money as opposed to beholden to the labels. I'd rather you see you put up the risk and you get the reward than them put up, because they're risking money when they invest in you. They're risking it. If it's a $10,000 advance, $50,000, $100,000, they're betting that they're going to be able to make, you know, 10 times of that plus back from you over a long period of time. Okay, so I hope this has helped you guys out to think about this. Leave a comment. Let's talk about this in the discussion. I'd like to hear what you guys think and ask some questions and some other pros and cons that I might not have covered in this, but at least get your brain thinking about what it is you're giving up by signing and what it is you're giving up going independent, and also what you're gaining by going independent, or what you're gaining, because there's two parts of it. There's two sides, and sometimes it's timing, sometimes it's where you are at your career, and what your end goal is, what your end dream is, and it's different for all of us. I am by no means trying to say, you know, just follow my career. My career path is the only way. There's so many ways of being successful in this industry that work. So hey, keep going. Leave a comment. Leave a review if you guys are digging this course so far. Hey, what's up, guys? Thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you found it valuable. Make sure you hit the subscribe button below so you can get notified of the weekly new updates we always put out. Also, if you're a struggling artist and you're just trying to figure out what to do next in this crazy music industry, maybe you feel overwhelmed and you just don't know what to do next, I want to encourage you to check out fanbaseuniversity.com. It's a membership area where we're helping hundreds of other artists grow their platform, grow their fan base, sell more music, the real nuts and bolts and the how-to to grow your music industry career. Head over to fanbaseuniversity.com and join our membership and get the help and the support you need to grow your music career.